Hello, good day to you, and God bless you. I'm Pastor Josh, and you're watching the Fellowship of the Living Word. God, the Holy Spirit. Though the crucifixion had bewildered, anguished, and terrified Jesus' followers, the resurrection brought mourning to their lives. When Christ broke the shackles of death, the kingdom of God dawned in their hearts. Now unquenchable fire burned within their souls. Differences that a few weeks earlier had erected nasty barriers among the disciples melted. They confessed their faults to one another and opened themselves more fully to receive Jesus, their ascended King. The unity of this once scattered flock grew as they spent day after day in prayer. One unforgettable day, they were praising God when a noise like the roar of a tornado ripped through their midst. As though the burning in their hearts were becoming visible, fiery flames descended on each head like a rampaging fire. The Holy Spirit descended upon them. Filled with the Spirit, the disciples could not contain their new ardent love and joy in Jesus. Publicly and enthusiastically, they began to proclaim the good news of salvation. Alerted by the sound, a multitude of local citizens, along with pilgrims from many nations, flocked to the building. Filled with amazement and confusion, they heard in their own language powerful testimonies to God's mighty works spoken by unsophisticated Galileans. "I don't understand," said some. "What does this mean?" Others tried to pass it off with "they're drunk." "Not so," Peter cried above the noise of the crowd. "It's only 9 o'clock in the morning. What have you heard and seen is taking place because the resurrected Jesus Christ has been exalted to the right hand of God and is giving us the Holy Spirit now." Acts chapter 2. And that'll conclude today's study. Until next time, I'm Pastor Josh signing off. God bless you and have a great day.